we have Dr. Parasuraman with us, and there is a big launch what he have done today. I'm going to speak to him very quickly and ask few of the good questions which will help the entire nation to know what are the new initiatives coming from Dr. Parasuraman. So very good evening, sir.
Good evening to you.
So the first question what I would like to ask is, like, today ISEI Index of Service Excellence in India is unveiled by you, right? So which perceived needs has led to the creation of such an index in India?
Well, one of the biggest perceived needs, as you term it, is actually the accelerating pace at which services are growing as part of the Indian economy. And even product companies are, you know, dime a dozen, in the sense that, you know, almost any category you take, mobile phones, automobiles, there are number of brands, they all can do the same thing. So how do product companies distinguish themselves? Once again, you know, it's through customer service. So because of these kinds of accelerated growth factors and also increasing emphasis on customer service is the primary driver of the need for this kind of an index at the national level. Yeah, and of course, there is no other national index. You know, companies do satisfaction studies and quality studies in a very limited basis, but there is no comparative standard.
So that's great to know that there's right. Nothing existing as such. The next question is the importance of the Index of Service Excellence in India and what does it aim to achieve?
Yeah, again, it's aimed to achieve multiple objectives. First and foremost, you know, it's a metric that is kind of like an overall barometer of the excellence of a particular company. And then when you make that kind of a index calculation for one company, you can do the same for other companies. So it facilitates kind of a top of the line overall comparison of companies within a sector as well as across sectors themselves. You know, what is the relative performance? Again, as driven and as from the customer's perspective in terms of the overall excellence of service. So it's a benchmarking type of capability, it's one major objective. And then apart from that, there are other objectives, you know, such as, you know, what are some of the common patterns? You know, when we make these comparisons and also go a little bit deeper and look at some of the things that are the foundational elements that lead up to the index, do we see some patterns? And if there are patterns, you know, why are the patterns occurring? So further questions can be asked based on the deeper dive information to feed some questions for research scholars as well as offer food for thought for practitioners.
Yeah. So I was observing on your one of the PPTs which you were sharing on the stage, like it would be important for everyone to know there as well. Like, what are the dimensions that are included in the index? A quick brief on that.
Yes, of course. Yeah. So this whole ISEI index is kind of based on a theory foundation called SERVQOL, you know, which is something which is a methodology for assessing service quality that I have, you know, developed over past 3 decades and applied in a number of different industries. So that is really the heart and the gut of this index, genesis of this index. So the SERVQOL methodology itself, I mean, it's based on a lot of different research, but at the fundamental level, it consists of, 5 major aspects or facets of customer service.
Right.
You know, tangibles, which has to do with appearance aspects, which is oftentimes the most visible part of the service. Then you have reliability, which has to do with, you know, to what extent is the company, regardless of what type of company, is dependable in terms of serving, providing service to customers. Responsiveness is another, you know, the third dimension, which has to do with the speed of the service and the general willingness to be responsive to customers and it's helpful to customers. Then another dimension is assurance. Assurance has to do with what are some of the things that the company does to build the customer's confidence that they are dealing with a trustworthy company, which is also part of service excellence. And the last one is empathy. Empathy has to do with to what extent does the company and its behaviors, you know, reflect the notion of taking the customer's perspective. You know, the dictionary definition of empathy is putting yourself in somebody else's shoes. So those are the 5 major elements. And the SERVQOL methodology is has been developed to assess customers, you know, what what they would expect on each of these five dimensions from a truly excellent company, even if it's a hypothetical company, relative to what they believe they're getting from an actual company with which they're actually interacting.
Right.
So those gaps are then the building blocks for the index.
Absolutely. Yeah. Right. So I'm sure like there will be a lot of questions and information what you still will be looking for to get from Dr. Parasuraman. So sir, where do I get more of the information where this people or the companies or admissions can go forward or
yes.
look forward for the information?
Yes, again, you know, along with the launch of the index today, we also announced the formation of the,
yes.
you know, the Center of Service Excellence. So one of the main goals as part of the vision of the center is to serve as a catalyst, both to generate knowledge, again, by making, you know, doing these kinds of investigations, and also disseminating knowledge. Which would involve, you know, answering questions that companies might have. So I welcome, you know, each and every company that is interested in customer care, customer service, achieving excellence through service, you know, to please, you know, be in touch with the center and become actually partners with the center.
Absolutely.
So we look forward to that as well.
So well, for everyone, IFIM-AIM, Parasuraman Center for Service Excellence is available. Please post down your questions. We'll be able to answer all the possible questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much.